So the final of the women's competition at the Australian Floorball Open is underway here at the Ray Owen Recreation Centre. Squishies from Melbourne in the yellow and green. Rampant meerkats from Western Australia in the black. Squishies didn't make the final in the women's competition last year, so good achievement for them. Tabby Hodges fired across the goal. Several players with the name Hodges in the Squishies team. As we see, number six, Joe Hodges. And coming forward to take the free hit, Shannon Hodges. Played back to Min Hodges. Stolen though well by Mel Cathy, the Australian international. Good ball forward finding Isabel Newland. Taken away though by Kate Van Acker. Will be the Meerkats though get the ball back. Lisa Sampi's pass across the back, then she gets the ball back, fires it in. And that was a good bit of defensive play by Shannon Hodges. Shannon Hodges on the ball again. Meerkats though, get the ball again. Squishies, Mel Cathy steals it back, the captain of the Rampant Meerkats. Squishies change their lines, as do the Meerkats. Ball just a little bit too far ahead of Ellen Williams. Now under a great deal of pressure from Hannah Hollands. That was well cut out by Shannon Salter. Certainly both these teams really going for it in the opening stanza. High press coming from the Squishies, but Cathy gets the ball across. Good block in the end from Kerry Lambie. Squishies applying the pressure. Meerkats having trouble getting out of defence at the moment. The ball has been stolen. Cathy couldn't carry it out of defence. It's taken back by Kaylee Tribe. Approaching the 5 minute mark in this women's final. Still nil-nil. Strong run by Tara Keogh. Stolen again by Hannah Hollands. Good awareness, driven in, the shot just coming off Hollands. Looked like it was goal banned and the sideboards have gone over on the far side. Play continues as they're quickly put back in place. Both teams changing their personnel. It's a poor clearance, but cleaning up was Joe Hodges and she accelerates into the Meerkats half. But Malcathy picks up the ball for the Meerkats. Goes behind a goal. Pushes forward, gets the return pass. Comes in, and that's a good interception in the end there by Shannon Hodges. It looked like Isabel Newland was in to score. Cathy, first time pass from Fiona Wainwright, finds Lisa Sampi. Sampi plays it in front of goal. But again, Squishies have numbers there, protecting their goal. Shannon Hodges under immense pressure along the backboards. And once again, the physicality of the challenges sees the boards take a bit of a hammering. Good play in the end by Tabby Hodges. She bursts down the right-hand flank. Ball, though, has been intercepted. Intercepted again, this time going the other way by Min Hodges. She carries it forward, but it's won again by Fiona Wainwright. This is going one way, then the other. Shot comes in, and a sharp save there by Sarah Moulton. And umpires are conferring. And there's a little bit of confusion. And the Meerkats are going to be a player down. Fiona Wainwright penalised for what appears to have been a stick check. So she will be on the sideline for 1 minute. Which means Squishies have a one-woman advantage for the time being. Good interplay again by them. Sharp pass going forward. Picked up by Kate Van Acker. Coming straight on with Ash Burke. Finds Van Acker going backwards. Slight miscontrol, but in the end it still gets through to the Squishies player. Turn and the shot. Forced wide. Good defensive play on that occasion by Tara Keogh. And Joe Hodges just using her physicality for the Squishies. Once again, we see the rampant Meerkats changing their personnel. Obviously, while they're a person down, it's another slowing down tactic. Just breaks up the rhythm of the game. Super run down the far side from Christina Orso. Draws the foul. Lisa Sampi back to Orso, back to Sampi. Carried forward by Min Hodges. Picked up off the backboards by Kaylee Tribe. Oh, and that was a definite push in the back on Lisa Sampi by Tribe. And that's going to be 2 minutes, a shake of the head from Kaylee Tribe. But she will spend 2 minutes on the side as we see Fiona Wainwright just making her way back onto the pitch. So suddenly, the numerical advantage shifts the way of the rampant Meerkats. Still 0-0 halfway through the first period. Patient build-up from the Meerkats. First time passing. Mel Cathy going back to Harrington. Harrington, the pivot at the back for the Meerkats, driven in by Malcathy. Just caught Wainwright on the back. And this will be a strong battle. Joe Hodges really loving the physical tussle up front. Quickly back though, while the Meerkats have that numerical advantage. Cathy along the boards. Comes back to Cathy again. Trying to drive that in first time was also. She's going to get a second bite of the cherry, though. Drives in behind the goal. Still with also. And the obstruction has been given, I think it was against Laura Cram. Not such accurate passing at the back, but Keo does well. And it finds also. Back to Keo. Almost left the ball behind. Driven across again, and Wainwright was coming in at the back post, just unable to get a touch. Cara Hodges was the keeper for the Squishies, made a relatively easy save. Tribe rejoins the fray, goes to close down Cathy straight away. That's a good pass, played across. Nobody there though for the Meerkats, played back again by Wainwright. A good break though from Joe Hodges. Joe Hodges, who has, like most of the Meerkats, one green sock, one yellow sock for the Squishies rather. Makes one wonder whether they just buy half the normal amount of pairs of socks and just split them up. Good attack for the Meerkats. Cassie Thorburn forced to play it back though. Played in front of the goal. Well positioned though was Ellen Williams. Seven and a half minutes remaining in the first period. Still nil all in this final of the women's event at the Australian Floorball Open, coming to you live from Ray Owen Recreation Centre in Les Murdies, Western Australia. Good communication from the captain, Ash Burke, telling Hodges to calm things down. That's Cara Hodges. Meerkats, and that was a risky ball, and in the end it comes to Sarah Moulton, who will be very pleased to have grabbed that. Kicked forward, great chance for the Squishies. Still going to be alive for the Squishies. Moulton with another sharp save, the ball's still loose. Squishies can't get a shot on goal, and they play it to the back of the circle. Nobody's there, and this will be a strong challenge coming in there from Tara Keogh. Meerkats, though, just unable to find anyone in front of goal. Now the shot comes in, and that was from Lisa Sampi, but well wide of the goal. Quick interchange once more from the Meerkats. Straight to Mel Cathy, tries a shot, it just pushes it wide. Trying to get on the end was Isabel Newland. Still alive for the Meerkats. Newland just missing that, just went behind her. If her stick had been down on the ground, she may well have deflected that in. Sharp save from Cara Hodges, although it wasn't going in. Five and a half minutes remaining in this first period, still nil-nil. Harrington playing it forward. She has bullseye written on the back of her shirt. Here she is again. Good turn from Harrington. Nice crossfield pass, looking for the runner Thorburn. Thorburn applying pressure, but illegally, according to the referee, and Van Acker wins the free hit and immediately is replaced. We're in the final 5 minutes of this first period. neither team has really stamped their authority or created any really great openings. It's just been a battle of attrition between the two. That was a good shot, just wide though, from Tara Keogh. Waves her stick in frustration, maybe feeling she should have done better. Ash Burke for Squishies. Switches play, but it'll be intercepted by Orso once more. Forced to go backwards by good pressure from Shannon Salter. Salter gets the ball back, played it across the pitch, but Tribe was unable to control it. Tribe, though, comes back and manages to steal it from Newland. Newland applies pressure. Meerkats get it back now through Laura Cram. But Squishies get it through Lamble. Mel Cathy tries to steal it back for the Meerkats. This game going one way, then the other. Shot coming in there from Cram. Now the Squishies try to mount a counter-attack. Stolen back by Cathy. What a sharp save that was from Cara Hodges. That was going in the top corner. And Hodges threw out her right hand and deflected it. Wonderful save. That was the best opening of this first period. Tribe again wins possession for Squishies. Leaves the ball. And just flicked out of play there by Keogh. Williams with the short pass played in, and that wasn't far away. Moulton was scurrying in goal for the rampant Meerkats. Once more, the Meerkats ring the changes. Just under 3 minutes remaining in this first period. Still 0-0 in this women's final. Best chance coming the way of Mel Cathy. And a sharp save by Hodges. A good ball across the goal, but no one was there. Cathy eventually came forward and picked it up. Plays it in again, and just unable to get on the end was Newland. As the boards take a tumble again. Ash Burke, the captain of Squishies, calming things down at the back and played it across and forward by Williams, but picked up by Cathy for the Meerkats once again. She plays it to the back of the D. The shot was slow coming, and Cram was forced to push it wide under pressure from Tribe. Tribe now has the ball for Squishies. Looks to try and find Salter, unable to do so. Good anticipation by Williams. Stolen it again, though, by Laura Cram. Ash Burke, though, picks it up for Squishies. Tries to keep possession. Free hit, though, goes the way of the Meerkats. Well, you just feel it's whichever team is going to make the first mistake at the back may pay heavily for it. Strong shot coming in, blocked again by Williams. Min Hodges looking for options going forward, plays it up the boards and manages to find Salter. Salter, though, can't get past Sampi. Sampi's pass goes to Williams, who plays it back to Shannon Hodges. Again, uses the board. Salter turns, but has Sampi in close attendance. Bit of a stalemate in the corner there. Eventually, the ball comes away, and cleaning up at the back is Keogh once more for the Meerkats. Another high press again from Squishies. Limiting it, good anticipation once more from Shannon Hodges. But the ball comes out, the goal's shifted. Shot comes in, just pushed wide by Hollands. Another great opportunity for the Meerkats to take the lead. We're in the final minute, still 0-0. Strong physical challenges, and it's not cleared well. Eventually fielded well by Cara Hodges between her legs, but she lived dangerously in that last few seconds of this first period. Min Hodges just slowing things down for Squishies. Goes the aerial route, not held, and helped out in the end superbly by Sampi was Moulton. Squishies still trying to get that goal in the final seconds. Draw the foul, 10 seconds left on the clock in this first period. Everyone except the Squishies goalkeeper inside the Meerkats half. Cathy will pick up off the boards, plays it forward early. The shot needs to come early, and that touch, there wasn't time for Hollands to take a touch, and she paid the price. She needed to take that first time with the defence scrambling back for the Squishies. Min Hodges slowing things down again as the hooter goes for the end of the first period. It's been end-to-end stuff, but on the scoreboard, neither team finding the back of the net. It is Squishies nil, Rampant Meerkats nil. Second period about to get underway in this Women's Australian Floorball Open final. 0-0 at the end of the first period. Squishies in the yellow and green, Rampant Meerkats in the black. Nothing to choose between the two teams, although probably the best chance fell to Mel Cathy from the Rampant Meerkats, and it was only a brilliant save by Cara Hodges in goal for the Squishies that prevented the Meerkats taking the lead. Good pressure from Newland. Wins possession for the Meerkats behind the Squishies goal. Cram going one way and the other, tries to play it for shot. What a shot that was from Cathy, and a good save again from Hodges. Don't think she knew a great deal about it. Wonderful strike from Mel Cathy first time, and Cara Hodges perfectly placed to block. Inch or two either side, and that was the opening goal. And you can hear the Squishies support getting behind their team. Almost playing herself in with Tara Keogh, but it was stolen by Lamble. Strong challenge again from Keogh, saying that it was all her stick, to the referee. Joe Hodges driving that in. Keogh again, and Hodges winning it back. There's several Hodges. That was Joe. Tribe with a shot. Good save this time from Moulton. Meerkats now go on the attack, this time through Thorburn. Thorburn still with the ball. Goes behind the goal. Finds Keogh. Keogh tries a first-time shot. Deflected well, though, by Van Acker. Strong challenge coming from Keogh, but Min Hodges holding her ground, and Keogh sighs when the free hit goes against her. Pressure applied and possession won back. Keogh, though, couldn't get past, and now the Squishies come on the attack again. Moulton saves. Bit of a mix-up at the back there as the Harrington tried to clear. Good communication, though. Joe Hodges calling for the ball at the back for the Squishies. Keogh blocks with her foot, and the ball ricochets to Min Hodges. Uses the boards well to Tabby Hodges. Just slowing the pace down was also, who then gets replaced. Mel Cathy pulls wide onto the right. Ball was played forward looking for Sampi, but she didn't manage to gain it. And Van Acker has it, but it's been stolen well. But stolen back, Newland couldn't keep possession. Cathy, though, has got possession back for the Rampant Meerkats. Close attention coming from Gabrielson. And Gabrielson winning the ball on that occasion, but it goes out of play. Wainwright. And missed passed and miscontrolled. Wainwright plays it off the boards, finds Cathy. Cathy hits the post! What a shot! Well, absolutely nothing that Cara Hodges knew about that. Then Moulton has to make a save the other end of the pitch to deny Tabby Hodges. This is end-to-end stuff in this women's final. No sooner had Mel Cathy hit the post than Tabby Hodges was shooting at the other end. And Sarah Moulton had to save. Strong challenges coming in once again from both teams. Surging run from Min Hodges, who takes a tumble on the far side, complains to the umpire, but play on is the call, and so the rampant Meerkats attack again. Cram limping, she got a bit of a strong challenge herself then. Wainwright cleaning up at the back for the Meerkats. Switching play, Keogh picks it up quickly, a strong challenge once more from Min Hodges. The shot came in just wide once more as Hodges was scrambling to get across. Orso's pass fails to find Keogh and gives the squishies an opportunity. Ashburke with a shot, wonderful claim by Sarah Moulton. One-handed catch in her right hand. Could get her a place in the Southern Stars, the Australian women's cricket team, with a snare like that. Sharp shot on the reverse stick coming in from Thorburn. Didn't find the mark. Once more we see the changes taking place for both teams. Cathy organising the centre of midfield. Thorburn looked like she'd stolen it. It will now come to the number 15, Herrington. Gives it to Cathy. One way, then the other. She plays it. It is gone in! First goal to the Meerkats. Mel Cathy, I think, is going to claim it. Did Hollands get a touch? I'm not so sure. But the Meerkats take the lead 7 minutes into the second period. And it was always going to be something special. And Cathy just moved one way, then the other, and then released a shot that found the back of the net. Now squishies have now got to fight their way back. Plenty of time, of course, left in the match, and here they come. Just pushed wide, trying to force that in was Gabrielson, but Moulton got back quickly. Well, squishies juniors were in the final, and they lost to the Redbacks earlier. They won't want to lose two finals in a row. Strong challenge from Fiona Wainwright. Oh, it looked like it was going to dribble in. Comes back, deflected, it's a goal! And that one came off of the defender, Jo Hodges. Sampi, I think it was, who played it in, but it came off the defender. 2-0 to the Meerkats. Face off to restart. Strong challenge coming in from Newland. So squishies find themselves going two goals down in 2 minutes. Good turn though from Tribe, but it's Meerkats on the attack again in front of the goal. Just forced wide was Cram. It was good play by Newland to set Cram up. Cathy wins possession back for the Meerkats. Happy to take it back inside her own half. Harrington played it forward again. Newland with a shot and a sharp save from Cara Hodges. Cathy communicating well with Christina Orso. And the ball coming off Tribe and out of play. Played forward, Keogh just losing control for a second. Sharp shot coming in from Tribe after good work from Salter. Thorburn chasing that down but couldn't get there. Ashburk, captain of Squishies, strong on the ball. Keeps possession, finds Lamble. Comes back to Burke. But just caught by a stick late. Not intentional from Wainwright, and an apology was issued. Mel Cathy switches play. Wainwright on the attack. Good block on that occasion coming from Lamble. Still with Wainwright. Call was have a look. Very difficult though when you have a player closing you down as tightly as Lamble is doing. But Wainwright has managed to keep possession. Fails to make the pass, left the ball behind. And once again we see interchange by numbers. Just click past the halfway point in the second period. Scoreline is 2-0 to the rampant Meerkats in black. Two goals in 2 minutes. Mel Cathy on the ball was the creator of the first one. I think she will be credited with it, although it, as the goal is really being pushed, and Sarah Moulton nearly had the goal come down on top of it. So we'll have a face-off. Smiles all around, everyone able to see the funny side. Cathy again, great body swerve from her. Lays it back to Orso. Orso gets it back. Cathy keeps moving. Draws defenders away with her, creating space for the Meerkats. Orso. Newland got in front of the defender. Cathy with a shot. Almost caught the backside of Laura Cram. And strong challenge coming in there. And we're going to see Joe Hodges spending some time on the side for an over-physical challenge. 2 minutes for a push. So the Meerkats have a one-woman advantage for 2 minutes. Can they make it count? They had the same in the first period and were unable to score as Keogh takes her eyes off the ball. Sort of mistakes that the Squishies will welcome. And they'll try and slow things down. Ash Burke quick to get on the ball, the captain of the Squishies. Shot from long range from Tribe. Also just taking her eye off the ball with the pass back to Wainwright, but Wainwright gets it again. Keogh to Cathy. Just got the ball stuck under her feet, back to Keogh. Wainwright. Just a slight mistake and she's lost possession. Tribe is through and Tribe pulls the goal back for the Squishies. Look what it means, they're one person down on the sideline. But Kaylee Tribe pulls one back for the Squishies. 2-1 now in favour of the rampant Meerkats. Six minutes remaining in the second period. It's been nip and tuck throughout this match. And just one mistake from Fiona Wainwright, and Kaylee Tribe pounced, giving Sarah Moulton no chance in goal for the Rampant Meerkats. Kathy, quick pass forward, finds Keogh. Forced to play it back. Comes out to Orso. Down the boards it goes to Mel Cathy once more. Cathy behind the goal. Keogh opens up for a shot. Really needed someone at the back post just to deflect that in. Emily Harrington stays calm at the back for the Meerkats. Just keeping possession as the Meerkats ring the changes once more. Wainwright looking for options. Uses Harrington. Dummied as if she was going back. Opens up infield. Loses possession. Ash Burke does well. Just wide from Joe Hodges, who's returned to the fray. Feisty character. Joe Hodges, really competitive out there. Wainwright looking to make amends. In behind the goal, can she find a teammate? She does. Plays the ball out to Thorburn. Thorburn, though, has to go back to Sampi. Sampi plays it in. But Holland's just unable to get on the end of it and direct it goalwards. Cathy again. Takes it behind the goal. Numbers of yellow shirts in front of the goal. Shot in and a good save once more by Cara Hodges. Pretty much directly at her, but you've got to be in the right position to make the save. Just drops the ball for Min Hodges. She holds play up. Then finds her captain, Ash Burke. Burke slows things down so the substitutes can get on, take up their positions. Gabrielson wanting the ball on the left-hand side. Goes the right-hand side. Strong challenge from Keogh on Min Hodges. Keogh comes out with the ball. Flicked towards goal by Sampi, but just wide. Keogh again, wayward pass, and Wainwright having to run all the way back to collect possession, and good support though coming from Sampi on the left-hand side. Keogh turns and goes solo. That avenue was closed down pretty quickly. Sampi though back to Keogh, and it was just wide. Thorburn tried a shot, but it was well blocked. Van Acker now, one way, then the other. Great steal by Wainwright, but still coming forward now is Min Hodges. And it's a save the other end of the pitch from Sarah Moulton. In the final 3 minutes of the second period, it was 0-0 at the end of the first. It is now 2-1 in favour of the Rampant Meerkats. And so much to play for in this women's final. In the final period, and what a goal! Mel Cathy out of nothing just flicked it towards the goal. And Cara Hodges appeared to lose it, and it just looped in on the left-hand corner. So it's now 3-1 to the Rampant Meerkats. What a time to score with 2.5 minutes left on the clock in the second period. Well, Squishies have sown plenty of character in this match. They're going to have to dig deep now, try and find another goal before the end of this period, or get one early in the final period. Ash Burke not happy with the decision. Driven forward by her. Stolen, but smothered in the end by Moulton. Lost against Salter. Saved by Moulton. Whistle had gone, but good snapshot from Salter. Just losing her bearings a little bit there was Tara Keogh. And Sharp save from Moulton, just taking away from Tribe. Fingertip save, in fact. Salter's going to claim it again. Strong defence, though. Wainwright battling hard for the Meerkats. Ball goes behind the goal. But it's going to be carried out well by Lamble. Well, that was a definite stick check, but Lamble keeps going. Had possession. Shot came in. Another sharp save from Moulton to deny Tribe. Wainwright, calm as you like, behind the goal. Cathy being urged on by the crowd. Reverse stick shot, and that's a good save this time from Cara Hodges, just flicking out her right leg. Burke again to Tribe, shot in, Moulton saves this time. Burke trying to win it back, Tribe has it back, quick flick shot, but it goes behind the goal and out of play. 1 minute remaining in this second period, end-to-end stuff. This has been a fantastic final from the ladies. Pressure applied again by Salter. Stolen once more by Williams. Good intercept though in the end by Harrington. Loses possession though. Lamble carries it forward, shoots, and this time Moulton grabs with her left hand. Cathy will be aware that there's only 38 seconds remaining. We'll slow things down for the Meerkats. Plays it forward. Harrington back to Cathy. Cathy shoots. Another great save this time from Hodges. Moulton grabs. Will take her time. Two players to her left. We're in the last 15 seconds of the second period. Wainwright comes infield, then we'll take it behind the goal. Try and run down the last remaining seconds of this period. Siren goes, and going into the final break, it is the Rampant Meerkats who have the ascendancy. 3 goals in that period means that they lead the Squishies by 3-1. Final period about to get underway here at the Australian Floorball Open 2014. The women's final against the Squishies in yellow and the Rampant Meerkats in black. The score at the moment is 3-1 in favour of the Rampant Meerkats as Mel Cathy gives us a little bit of jig on halfway. Two captains having plenty of smiles. That's the way you like to see finals played, in a good spirit. But you can be assured as soon as the hooter goes, that will all go out the window. We're underway. 20 minutes to decide who is the Australian Floorball Open champion in the women's competition. Can the Rampant Meerkats hang on? Ashburg, lovely turn to pull away. Good ball infield to find Lamble. Stolen though well by Newland. Lamble has to retreat. She's under pressure from Cram. Cram gets a stick in. May have stolen possession. Gets a stick on around the back of the legs from Lamble. And strong physicality. Newland just couldn't get ahead of Williams. Otherwise it could have been 4-1 to the Meerkats. Desperate defending though by Williams in the end to clear the danger for the Squishies. Squishies, high press from the Meerkats. Good pass forward, stolen again but illegally against Van Acker. Driven in, that hit the crossbar. Well, from a long way out, Min Hodges, out of nothing, hits the crossbar. And so often, games are decided by those fine margins. What that would have meant to the Squishies to get a goal that early in this final period. Still alive for them, shot comes in, Moulton does well to save and deny Tabby Hodges. One gets the feeling there are more goals to come in this final period. Harrington played forward to Keogh. Keogh behind the goal. Strong challenge from Van Acker. Keogh manages to hang on to possession, turns. Van Acker still in close attendance. Keogh leaves the ball behind and Van Acker claims it. Good play by Kate Van Acker. Has one sock up and one sock down. Ellen Williams. Kathy, two goals, good save once more by Hodges. Cara Hodges, that is. We have a plethora of Hodges. I don't know what you'd call more than three or four Hodges on the pitch, but plenty of them. And now Williams is assisting the referees. And she gets the decision right. So Williams to Burke. Kathy looking to close her opposite number down, the captain of the Squishies, went into the back of Williams. Collision between the two Meerkats players and Ash Burke quick to pounce. Spins away from Kathy, but pass goes to Wainwright, who finds Kathy again. Shot comes in and Cara Hodges gets her hands there but couldn't hold on. Comes back out. Tribe now tries to get past Wainwright. Will be picked up by Cram, but lost. Tribe trying to get forward. Crucial interception there by Lisa Sampi. Mel Cathy lifts it forward and Cara Hodges claims it with ease. And just drops the ball down for Kerry Lamble. Good close control there from Sampi. Tribe just poking it away. Sampi trying to get a shot in. Strong challenge again. Can Newland get the shot away? Williams just got a vital touch and took it away to Lamble. And Lamble now has been dispossessed by Wainwright. Ball comes infield to Cram. Wainwright will clean up. One mistake from her led to a goal, but she's been solid apart from that one little error. Good control from Wainwright. Comes back to Keogh. Thorburn trying to help it on, but just misdirected it, and Van Acker will claim possession for the Squishies. Played along the backboards, and Joe Hodges will pick up for the Squishies. Looks for options going forward. Eventually the ball comes all the way through to Tabby Hodges. Tries a shot, little touch from Moulton as it goes past, and it will be the Squishies ball. Min Hodges over the ball for the Squishies, plays it forward. Just a nice little stick poke, taking it away by Hollands. And once again, Joe Hodges looks for options and misdirects a pass to Min Hodges. Harrington, short pass back to Orso, who switches play out to Kathy, back to Orso, back to Harrington. Driven in just off the post and unable to grab it was Cara Hodges. Good use of the foot at the back by Orso. Kathy comes infield, tries a reverse stick shot. Good grab this time by Cara Hodges. That was through a crowded area. She would have seen it very, very late. Orso again, using her body well. Mel Cathy, one way then the other, opens up a bit of space, plays it across, but a good intercept by Gabrielson. Driven in again, claimed by Ash Burke. And Burke driving it into the Meerkats player and out of play. All the players running for the sideline as we see substitutions happening thick and fast. Lamble. Tribe getting the sole goal for the Squishies at the moment, makes her way forward for this free hit. Squishies supporter base getting behind their team. 13 minutes remaining in this final period. Squishy's losing 3-1 at the moment. Keogh's done well in a foot race with Burke, but Burke eventually comes out with the ball, plays it forward. Good challenge coming in from Sampi, and that was a very physical challenge. And two squishies hit the deck. Keogh, though, gets the free hit. Comes back to Keogh, sweeps it in. It just whistled past the right-hand post of Cara Hodges, and she exhales deeply. Twelve and a half minutes remaining in this women's final at the Australian Floorball Open 2014, coming to you from Les Murdie in Western Australia. Good block by Van Acker, using her body well. Comes back now to Jo Hodges, under pressure from Cathy. Good shielding from Hodges. Strong challenge coming in, this time from Tabby Hodges. And also helping out was Gabrielson. Good save again. Also to Cathy. Cathy picks out Harrington. Harrington having to go back as Tabby Hodges closed down the option going forward. Mel Cathy. Good pass from her, lifted by Wainwright. Newland. Good skill by Cram, looking for Wainwright, but it deflected to Gabrielson. Cram's done well to get it back. Newland, snapshot, but just wide. In a good position was Isabel Newland, but just unable to find the target. Maybe her body position was a little bit square. Squishies with the ball through Lamble. Williams loses out to Hollands. Hollands plays it back across, trying to get the shot away, cleaned up by Ashbrook. Thorburn couldn't get the shot away. Another chance comes, and it's just gone wide from Hollands this time, but the whistle had already gone for a foul going the way of the squishies. Ashbrook trying to get her team going. Aerial pass cut out well by Wainwright. Lost it though momentarily. It's still alive for squishies. Wainwright just clears the lines. Keogh, strong challenge, and it just goes out of play. Williams to her captain Burke. Manages to turn well. Can't get past Keogh. Keogh dispossesses, surges forward, just needed to push it a little bit ahead. It comes back to Keogh now, trying to find Hollands, but again the ball just went behind her. And squishies get it back through Lamble. Pressure from Thorburn. Lamble eventually comes back onto the right hand side. Chasing forward now is Shannon Salter. Wainwright, though, collects for the Meerkats. Burke puts it in the back of the net, but the whistle had already gone, and there's boos from the Meerkat supporters. Comment from someone in the crowd saying that's the only way they'll score. Ash Burke just looking in the direction from which the comment came. Newland, and Newland gets a fourth for the Meerkats. She just opened herself up as the ball ran across her and flicked it to the left-hand side of Cara Hodges to make it 4-1 to the rampant Meerkats. And maybe now that is the winner, because they have 8.5 minutes in which to find 3 goals. And Ash Burke has just asked for a timeout. So Squishies are really going to have to regroup now. They're three goals down, 8.5 minutes remaining. And you would think that that fourth goal is going to be the difference between them hauling anything back in this game. It was a great finish by Isabel Newland. The ball was rolling towards her. She opened her body up so that she could fire the shot into that left-hand corner. And Hodges had to cover the near post. So the Squishies come back out for the face-off to get us underway after that fourth goal. Burke battling hard centre field. Wainwright again. Just the ball, though, bouncing behind Thorburn and out of play. Screaming for a ball. And eventually one comes in from the opposite side of the pitch. Tribe trying to drive it forward, but straight into the Meerkats defenders. Wainwright plays the ball forward for Thorburn. No one closing Thorburn down. If she's clever, she can pick out a teammate, but decides to take the ball behind the goal. And the umpire's getting plenty of assistance now from Squishy's players. Ball being placed so the free hit can be taken quickly by Min Hodges. It's a fairly errant pass on that occasion by Christina Orso. Harrington doing well under close attention from two Squishies players. Burke may well have stolen it. She has. Keeps possession, flicks it goalwards, but just couldn't keep it down, but it came off a Meerkat stick. So it will be a Squishies ball. Burke again moves across to assist. Kaylee Tribe over there as well. Burke to Tribe, sweeps it in, it's a goal! Kaylee Tribe gets a second goal of the match, and it is now 4-2 in favour of the Meerkats with 6 minutes 45 seconds remaining. Can the Squishies get two more goals? They're going to have to really play well, but they're making an inroad. Free hit goes the way of Squishies, taken quickly by Ash Burke, but lifting it high, gets a pat on the back from Min Hodges. Fiona Wainwright plays it along behind the goal. Strong challenge coming in from Hannah Hollands. Lisa Sampi. Over the ball for the rampant Meerkats. Gets the ball back. Tries to squirt it across the goal, but it was too high, too strong, and misdirected. Tribe involved again. Dangerous ball and dangerous challenge. Jo Hodges will battle hard and apply the pressure as she's done throughout the game. Wainwright, two Squishies players, and Burke fired a shot across the goal. Jo Hodges again, and Ash Burke just throwing herself. And of course, not allowed to do that. She threw the ball away. And Ash Burke is now going to probably spend a few minutes on the sideline. 2 minutes. 5 minutes remaining. And Squishies down to four outfield players and their keeper. A little bit of frustration showing from the Squishies captain. It was desperation followed by frustration. Keogh to Wainwright, back to Keogh. All they've got to do is keep possession. and run the clock down. 4.5 minutes remaining. Possession floorball is all that's needed. Wainwright plays it in, looking for the deflection. Mel Caffey gets a hat-trick. And that has probably sealed the match for the Rampant Meerkats. Moulton comes out to celebrate. The subs come on and join in the celebrations as Caffey goes across and salutes the fan base on the far side. Five-two now in favour of the Rampant Meerkats. Ash Burke is back out there, so parity in terms of numbers on the pitch. Strong challenges coming in still. Great run by Laura Cram. Gets a little bump in the back, plays it in front of goal. Caffey frustrated, she couldn't get there. That just whistled past Cara Hodges' left-hand post. Cram battling hard, so too is Christina also. She'll be penalised though for a little push in the back. Caffey takes that ball full on, also takes that one. Anything will do from the Meerkats now, just getting their bodies in the way of the ball. Burke with a shot, just goes past the left-hand post of Moulton's goal. Harrington finds Mel Caffey, she cuts infield, gets closed down. Strong challenge coming in from Tribe, and she's penalised for it. Just under 3 minutes remaining. Possession given away. Salter goes on the attack, deflected away, but Tara Keogh comes up with the ball for the Meerkats. Strong challenge again from Tribe. Try battling hard, but not legally at the moment, according to the referees. Thorburn, good use of the body. Strong challenge coming in there from Ellen Williams, and an illegal one. Rampant Meerkats take their time. Hannah Hollands over the ball. Gives it to Keogh. Plays it back to Sampi. Wainwright finds Kia with a good crossfield pass, lifted and it deflected off Burke's stick. Thorburn has got it under control on the far side, comes back to Wainwright, played in. Kia didn't get the touch, was trying to find Hannah Hollands, and she's got a battle for the ball against the boards with Williams. Williams looks to have got it, and it's been taken away by Salter. Stolen back though by Sampi. Sampi's shot goes wide. And again, desperate lunge from Ash Burke. Crowd really appreciating this fantastic final from the women here at the Australian Floorball Open 2014. Caffey playing it forward. Newland looking for a second goal. Just letting the ball run there was also. Caffey picks it up again. Pressure being applied once more by Gabrielson, but Caffey's got time and space now. Gabrielson comes forward, Caffey leaps it forward, brought down under control by Joe Hodges. Battling for possession once more was Laura Cram. She's been busy in the second half. Min Hodges surges forward. Can't get past though Christina also, but has possession still. Played across the goal, came off Moulton. Caffey cleans up. Coming in again is Gabrielson, applying pressure. She's stolen possession. Caffey gets the ball back though for the Rampant Meerkats and slows things down. Helter skelter last 3 or 4 minutes here. Harrington, close attention, loses possession. Gabrielson surges forward, tries the shot. Caffey comes up with possession once more. What a game Mel Caffey has had in this final. Great leadership, she's also got 3 goals to her name. Has the ball again, finds Wainwright. Again, very composed at the back, Fiona Wainwright. Caffey goes back to Wainwright again. Makes headway forward, gets over halfway, shields the ball well. We're in the last 30 seconds of the match. It is going to be a Rampant Meerkats victory. Wainwright plays it forward. Cara Hodges tries to get on with it quickly. Finds Tabby Hodges. Possession has been lost. Thorburn tries to get it, just plays it into the corner. Cram chasing it, the Meerkat supporters find their voice as once again the ball goes out of play off Thurbrunn. 5 seconds remaining. Squishy's complaining that the clock did not stop while the ball was out of play, and they have a valid point. 10 seconds, the referee has said, remaining. Ashbrook tries a shot, blocked, cleared, anywhere will do for the Meerkats at the moment. Once again, Joe Hodges tries to muscle her way through and wins a free hit. Ashbrook has been everywhere, drives it in, just past the far post, and you can't hear the siren go, and Squishies sink to the ground. The Meerkats go into a huddle and celebrate an epic victory. But what a game we've witnessed. Both teams giving their all, but on the day, it was the rampant Meerkats who were victorious, beating the Squishies by 5-2.